Criminal charges have police say she did the unthinkable, throwing away her newborn baby like a piece of trash. And it was all caught on surveillance video. Giuli Frednik has the story, and I do want to warn you, this story contains video that's certainly going to be found disturbing to some viewers.
To anyone else, this video looks like a woman throwing away a bag of trash. But now we know what was inside that bag was a precious treasure. Police believe you're watching 18-year-old Alexis Avila of Hobbs throw her living newborn baby into an area dumpster.
Something wasn't right. I saw the officers' faces, and they did not look right. They really didn't.
Joe Imbriali owns Riggs Outfitters in Hobbs. He says police called him Friday night with a request to view his surveillance footage.
I said, what is it we are looking for? And she goes, we're looking for somebody that dumped a black garbage bag in your dumpster. And I turned around and said, please don't tell me it was a baby.
The video shows who is believed to be Avila leaving the dumpster at 2 Friday afternoon. 6 hours later, you can see three people searching through the same dumpster. They pull out a black bag and start looking through it. Seconds later, a woman reacts to what's inside and starts opening the bag. She pulls out the newborn baby, still alive, and tends to it. Once the child is wrapped up, she brings it to their truck while a man in the group is on the phone. They pull the truck away from the dumpster, and you can see police and an ambulance arrive minutes later. Police immediately start looking in the dumpster, and paramedics take the child to a local hospital.
I was in shock just to see this.
Imbriali couldn't believe his eyes as he reviewed that video with police.
Yeah, I can't sleep at night just knowing that this baby was tossed in a dumpster like that. I'm sorry, but who does it? That is evil. That is just...
And right now here at 5:30, we are getting some new information about a family tragedy in Hialeah Gardens. A woman shot and killed on her birthday. And police were called to an apartment late last night after neighbors reported hearing gunfire.
The victim's 14-year-old son was shot, and investigators say it was her live-in boyfriend who pulled the trigger. Local 10's Roy Ramos live with the latest on the investigation. Roy.
Louie and Christy, this family just devastated by all of this, still trying to make sense of what exactly happened here. Meanwhile, it's police who say on the second floor of this apartment building, this man shot and killed his girlfriend, then shot her 14-year-old son before turning the gun on himself. Relatives of 45-year-old Angelina Rodriguez telling Local 10 the mother was shot and killed by her boyfriend on her birthday. The shooting happening at Rodriguez's home around 10 Sunday night. Hialeah Gardens police said when officers arrived, they found her body near the front door of her second floor apartment. But as they made their way further inside the unit, they found her boyfriend and 14-year-old son also shot. As the two were rushed to the hospital in critical condition, investigators learned it was Rodriguez's boyfriend who shot the mother and her son before then turning the gun on himself. For hours, we watched as family and friends gathered outside the home, now struggling to understand what led up to the fatal shooting.
Identified the victim as 41-year-old Alejandro Garcia. They say that he was a family man, a father of three, and a hard worker. He worked at the Taco Bell one night out of the week to provide for his family, and now his family is mourning his death.
He was a hardworking man, a family man, and for him just to die, just horrible.
Horrible and inconceivable. Nancy Del Sol's cousin, 41-year-old Alejandro Garcia, was shot and killed on the job at a Taco Bell Saturday night in South LA. He was working the evening shift alongside his 19-year-old son.
The way that he died in front of his son, it was really, really traumatic experience for my nephew.
Police say Garcia was working the drive-through window at the Taco Bell on Avalon and Century Boulevards when a man approached the window and tried paying for his food with a counterfeit bill.
When he didn't want to take the bill and he didn't want to pray any service, I guess they got upset and they start shooting. And
Del Sol says her nephew tried to intervene.
My nephew was close by, so he closed the window, but the shots, they went in and he got shot on the heart, and the fuck killed him, and he died there in front of his presence. And
police say they don't yet have
tracking in Southwest Houston. A shooting left a 15-year-old girl dead. Her family says the violence happened while she was out walking the dog.
We are also told the teenager was shot 22 times. Brittany Jeffers is live on the story near the teen's home, which is on Park Manor and Markwood Lane. Brittany, good morning.
And good morning to you. An absolutely devastating case. I spoke with the family members about an hour ago who are truly heartbroken. They tell me the victim in this case, 15-year-old Diamond Alvarez, they tell me that she left the home. She was out walking in the area, taking the family dog for a walk around 8 o'clock, but she never came back. Instead, family members tell me they found her in this field, shot to death. This morning, you can see a memorial starting to grow in her honor. Now, if you take a look, the family shared this photo with us. This is 15-year-old Diamond. They say a sophomore at Madison High School. Her mother and stepfather tell me that she walks the family dog Peanut out here in this field every day. The family lives just a few blocks from here, and they say that it was the dog who alerted them that Diamond was in trouble.
He's the one who let us know something was wrong, because he's the one who went in the door and we knew that when he came back by on his own, that something was wrong.
Houston police tell us that they were called out to the scene in Southwest Houston around 9:30 last night. They say victim died at the scene, and at this point they have not identified any suspects other than that the shooter may have been in a dark-colored vehicle heading northbound. Now, family members out here...
attack inside a deli. A woman armed with a hammer, police say, her partner with a gun. Now, the shot fired missed the intended target. The victim's ultimately going to be okay. But News 4's Gabby Acevedo spoke with the owner. He's live now in the Van Ness section of the Bronx. Gabby.
David, and the bodega owner, Ali Sala, who has been here for at least a decade as a business owner, tells me that this happened at the very heart of the Yemeni-American community here in the Bronx, now concerned about yet another violent attack. Surveillance video shows what happened inside Quick Stop Mini Market on the night after Christmas around 10 p.m. Police say a man and a woman got physical with a 50-year-old man inside the bodega on Morris Park Avenue. One of the attackers pulled out a gun.
I have my stuff was working in the night. I wasn't here at the scene, but I was worried about my employees to get hurt.
Ali Sala has owned this bodega for the last 8 years. He says something like this has never happened inside his store.
What happened right now, it's like I've been for a long time in this country, but I never see that bad.
The woman takes out a hammer and hits the victim in the head several times outside the bodega. The guy takes out his gun again and fires it, not only missing the victim, the bullet striking the side of the store.
Well, hits the wall right there in the bottom of his seat under the window.
Stabbing in Harlem. It happened at about 9:30 last night on West 132nd Street near Lenox Avenue. Investigators say a 40-year-old Mount Vernon resident was stabbed in the neck after a dispute. He was rushed to Harlem Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. Police say they're searching for at least two suspects who ran from the scene and into a car.
A desperate man looking for help on a quiet residential street in Plum after he was shot several times. Good afternoon, and thanks for watching KDK News at Noon and CBSN Pittsburgh. I'm Lindsay Ward. That was the scene last night on Emerald Drive, and now police say they have a woman in custody. Our Bryant Reed joins us live with more details for us. Bryant?
Lindsay, police say it all started with an argument that led to a breakup, and then gunfire. They say 38-year-old Crystal Veasley was visiting from Ohio. She was in a relationship with the victim, Glenn Smith Jr. And during the argument, police say the couple broke up and Smith told Veasley to leave his house. That's when Smith says he turned around to find Veasley pointing a gun at him. Police say Veasley fired several times, striking Smith several times in the chest, shoulder, and hand. The two got into a physical fight before Smith ran outside looking for for help. Meantime, BC ran to the kitchen for a knife and began to chase after him. KDKA has obtained Ring doorbell footage that shows the victim in the middle of the road calling for help. Neighbors say VC then ran to her car and took off. Police found her several miles away from the scene. One neighbor in the area said he and his family got caught in the crossfire when three bullets flew into their home and they had to dive on the floor to protect their two-year-old child. Now, VC is in Allegheny County Jail currently with three charges against her, one of them being tampering with evidence, another being aggravated assault, and the last being attempted homicide. Reporting live, I'm Brian Reed, KDKA News.
Overnight, a toddler shot and killed. Now relatives are searching for answers. You're watching News Channel 3's Live at 9. I'm Zunetta Lowe in for Mary Beth Conley this morning.
And good morning. I'm Alex Coleman. We've been following breaking news all morning long for you. Memphis police say the young boy died after someone opened fire outside his home. WREG's Jarita Patterson is live from Clayton Avenue after just speaking with family members of that young victim. Jarita, good morning.
Yeah, good morning to you both, Zanetta and Alex. I can tell you just minutes ago, the family actually welcomed us into their home, which is just behind me, willing and wanting to share precious memories of this precious toddler. They're telling us he was a Spider-Man and Avengers fanatic, just 2 months away from celebrating his third birthday. The family identifying the victim as 2.5-year-old Charvez Atkins, who was killed while he was simply playing inside his room, again, at this Clayton Avenue home. It is very important, folks, that we show you, if we haven't already, who the victim was, who was victimized by violence just overnight. We're going to put up photos, again, if we haven't already. The shooting happening along Clayton Avenue, just off of Chelsea Avenue. Minutes ago, his aunt, while fighting back tears, telling us shots were fired outside the Clayton home during the overnight hours. This is Charvez's grandmother's house, by the way. When the shooting stopped around 10 o'clock last night, the family quickly discovered the toddler was hit. He was rushed to Lebanon Children's Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. Police quickly putting up that yellow crime scene tape. Now, in addition to the web of crime scene tape, there was also a web of confusion. As Memphis police were originally reporting, this was a double shooting, but after pressing for more answers, detectives are now telling us there was just the one victim. Sadly, the victim, 2.5-year-old Charvez. We're asking
about a domestic homicide investigation is unfolding in Montgomery County. A mother is now dead and a father is now in custody. This happened outside of a bank in the Colesville area of Silver Spring. And Fox Eye Sierra Fox was first on the scene and she joins us now live with the details. Sierra.
Good evening, Rob. Well, Montgomery County police say that a husband ran over his wife in this Capital One Bank parking lot behind me around noon. Just take a look at this unfolding scene here along New Hampshire Avenue in Silver Spring. Police tell us a 59-year-old woman went to the bank to take care of some business, and when she came outside, her 59-year-old husband was in a white SUV. They say he first slammed into a front column of the Capital One Bank, then ran over his wife before knocking over a light pole in the parking lot, which the vehicle is still stuck on top of. No one was in the SUV, and the suspect is in custody being questioned by investigators. Right now, family is being notified, so at this time, the name of the victim has not been released. According to police, there was no exchange of words, an argument, or fight prior to the wife being killed, and it's not clear what led up to this deadly incident. Just to express the magnitude of the scene out here, a woman just approached me and asked, is this a movie? Is a movie being shot here? Now, police do want the
jewelry ends with a man and a woman being arrested. This happened at a house in the Woodmont subdivision north of Foley. Investigators say it started with an argument over jewelry between Camilla Gay and her boyfriend. Now, we're told that it escalated to the point where Gay shot the man in the stomach. He was taken to South Baldwin Regional Medical Center, then later flown to a hospital in Pensacola, where he's in stable condition. Gay has been charged now with domestic violence.
Now to a disturbing attack in the Bronx. A woman on her way home was punched, kicked, and stabbed 13 times by two men she says she didn't know. These two men are still on the loose tonight. Cops need your help tracking them down. News 4's Mark Santia has the story and the exclusive video you'll see only here on News 4.
The mother of the victim tells us her daughter has been released from the hospital. She's recovering, and the entire family is praying for an arrest. Exclusive new video of two men who police say attacked and stabbed a woman here on 198th Street near Valentine Sunday morning.
I saw a lot of blood right over here on the floor. Some over here by the trees. There was just blood on the gate. So it looked like she was probably trying to get up and trying to get away from it.
Sahara Bernard saw all the blood, but had no idea what happened until she saw this video.
Oh. Yeah, see, no one deserves that. No one ever deserves that.
The mother of the 28-year-old victim, who did not want to go on camera, tells us her daughter does not know the men. She did not know why she was followed, attacked, stabbed 13 times, and left for dead.
You know, she's a good girl.
Living in the Bedford Park section for more than 40 years.
A woman has been struck and killed by a subway train. Police say a man pushed her onto the tracks at the 42nd and Broadway station. Happened around 9:30. Authorities are on the scene, and we're told the suspect is in custody.
New video shows a man who police say posed as a food delivery worker to enter a building in the East Village where he shot a man to death. 30-year-old Devon Venable was killed inside his family's apartment at the Lillian Wald Houses on Friday night. A police source tells us the gunman knocked on the door, which was answered by the victim's father. The suspect then asked if someone had called for an Uber before pulling out a gun and firing. Police are still searching for that suspect who fled on a bike.
And with breaking news,
a 15-year-old girl found dead on a street in Brooklyn, the victim of an apparent hit and run. CBS News' Nick Calloway is live at the scene in Midwood with more. Nick?
Well, Cindy and Chris, the girl was walking in or near that crosswalk right over there just before 8 a.m. this morning. That's when police believe she was hit by a vehicle. Police got a call about a pedestrian struck on Bedford Avenue and Avenue P. They found a 15-year-old girl lying in the roadway with injuries consistent with being struck by a car. The driver of that vehicle left the scene, and police say the girl died. No vehicle description has been released by police just yet. Now, Bedford Avenue is still closed at this hour. Investigators are still here on the scene trying to figure out exactly what happened and who was the driver of that car that fled the scene after that girl was killed. Reporting live in Midwood.